Isis Audiobooks presents an unabridged recording of Down Cemetery Road, written by Mick Herron, read by Anna Bentinck. When he opened his eyes, he expected to find all the light squeezed from the world. But no, he was alive still, strapped to a bed in a sterile room, angry red claws of pain scratching channels in his flesh. "They have tied me down to keep me from shredding myself," he managed in a moment of clarity, "to prevent me ripping the skin from my bones and not stopping until I'm dead." This was a good thought. It pretended they had his welfare in mind. But the pain remained, like being chewed by fire ants, and even when he slept he felt it working in his dreams. In his dreams, he was back in the desert. His companions were dead soldiers, their meat dropping off their bones. The loudest thing in life was a helicopter. All around, the boy soldiers disintegrated, made puddles in the sand. Here, when he was awake, there were other noises to occupy him. Outside his room, he imagined a long corridor of swept tiles and white light, an echoey tunnel that carried sounds past his door, some of which lingered to mock his boredom. A dropped fork rattled in his mind for hours. He heard voices too, a low mumble that never separated into language. And once he thought he heard Tommy. Thought he recognised a man he knew in a noise mostly animal. A rising scream cut off by a slammed door. Footsteps clattered into distance. Something on wheels, might have been a trolley. He tried to shout a response, but his voice got lost in the deep caverns of his pain, and all he could do was weep silent tears that scorched his cheeks. A doctor came once a day. He had to be a doctor. He wore a white coat. The nurse with him carried a tray. On it, a precise array of tools, different-sized needles, small bodies of coloured liquids. Both nurse and doctor wore gloves and surgical masks, and both had olive skin and hazel eyes.